So in the previous video, we went over where to edit tables and forms and stuff like that. We're going to do it through make.powerapps.com and not the old customizations within CE. So what we're going to do here is build out a form. It's a project planner form, and the idea is we need to store the data somewhere. We need to allow someone to enter the data into something. So when dealing with Dynamics CE and model-driven Power Apps, which is really what this is, you always start at the database and the tables. So there's going to be lookups into accounts, into contacts, but we need to store that some information somewhere. So what we're going to do is create a new table, and we're going to call it add-on sales. Now, we will enable attachments and stuff. Let's look at some other options. Standard. Nope, it's just going to be a standard table. We do want a user or team versus the organization, because we want to know who is the one that created this record. So that's where we get the user. We can choose an image. We'll come back if we want to choose an image, but for now, keep that. For this table, we don't need any of this. Let's keep looking at this, but each of these has an option here, so you can click on it and go to it to get more information. Okay. Rose can admission, that's by his team. So pretty basic, just simple table. We will have a primary column. Now, the primary column is, the way we're building this out is really a primary column could just be an auto ID, and that would be fine. So we're gonna make this just optional, because it's not really a field that we need. But what we can do is call this to make this the description of the project. So we're going to go back to required, and instead of name, we're going to say now for this one, because it's a description, we're going to go a little higher on the max characters. So we've got a table right now, it's going to call it add-on sales, and then we're going to have a primary column called description. Save. Now, based on this table, we're going to have to link in and create link in some other tables, but also create some fields. So once we come into it, creates the table. Now what we'll have is one column called description. Now there are 18 other columns, but these are standard columns. You've got statuses, versions, owners, and stuff like that. We want to create additional columns. So come over, we're going to edit. New column, and I want to call this one special circumstances is actually going to be a multi-line. Where's multi-line again? Text area. Not calculated, just gonna be simple, and it will be just optional for this one. Let's see if there's anything else. So this is where we're gonna make this much larger. We're gonna make this character. quick save. Another new column, we're going to call it additional notes. Same thing. Now, one of the things I am going to put is my client here, edit the column, and in this description, I'm going to say, are there special circumstances, dates, so that we know what the date is for, or sorry, the field is for. Now, there's going to be four more initial columns. Actually, we're going to go five. We're going to go another one here that's going to say other not listed. And I don't remember, I made a mistake. We'll go 1,000 here. I'll have to go back to additional notes and make sure it's large enough. We're going to come in here, go new count. We're going to say institution name. Now, this one's actually going to be a lookup to a customer. What's nice about doing the lookup is it automatically creates the relationship. Now, what you're seeing here, because I selected customer, it's actually going to create a link to an account and a contact. So in this case, I don't want that. I actually just want it to be directly to the account. So I'm gonna come back in here, do a lookup. The required field is an account. And now we just have a single relationship that goes directly to the account. This is actually very nice because it saves you time from having to create the relationship. It's going to be a lookup. Now, when we talk about relationships inside of CRM, we will get to that in a little bit because we're going to be tying this to products and a grid. So within relationships, we've got one to many, many to one, and many to many. So what that means is I have one record and I can pull on many contacts. So I have one account, many contacts. But a contact can only have one account. But many contacts can have the same account. So it's many to one versus one to many. One to many from account to contact. Many to one from contact to account. So here we're going to create a new field. We want date only. Now, this comes a little issue with what we're going to do here. We can do the date, but we're going to go, you know, date only, user local, and then time zone independent. We're just going to go with keep it user local. It'll change for the persons entering the dates, whatever time zone they're in. Here we're also going to do contact. Now, contact again is going to be a lookup. And yes, I know we could have done one field that can look up in an institution or a contact, but I wanted them separate. And one of the things we will do at some point down the line, we're going to look and see, can we tie these together? And so when the contact is filtered by the institution. But for now, we're going to keep it here as the contact. And then there's another field, and this one's going to be an interesting one because it's contacts email. And I'm going to put it on here there are different methods of needing the email or needing another record from showing a record from another entity. Again, we're going to leave this here, but we may end up deleting it or utilizing it in a different way, because we can create quick views and show the contact's email based on the contact selected. And that is the more effective and efficient way. So we're going to go for that in a little bit. But I want to put it in there so that there's another approach we can do with JavaScript and stuff like that to pull records. So right now we've created a table called add-on sales. What we're going to do now is go back. We're actually going to create another table. Now, if I click here, we're in this table, so I have to go back out to tables again. Click a new table, and I'm going to call it add-on sales products. Now, what this is going to do, and again, this all is fine. Primary key here is going to be just name. We're good with that one for now. This is actually going to have a relationship between add-on products and add-on sales. So add-on sales products and add-on sales. So what I'm going to come here, click on relationships. I'm going to go new relationship. Now, this can be many to one or many one to many. In our case, I want each of these products to have one add-on sales. So it's many to one. Add-on sales. Lookup column description. So we're good there. Now in here, we got type of behavior. Now again, you can click on these things. So referential, any records navigated to, you can read what these are as you were going. So something like this, I'm good with referential. And if you delete, you remove the link. Now, again, you could do different ones like parental. Any action taken on the record of the parent table is also action. So if we delete the parent, the children go away. And that may be the best one for now. So let's do that. Add on sales products. Lookup columns, add on sales. Done. What this will allow us to do is when we add a product to the grid, it knows which add-on sales it is associated with. Once this is created, there's one other field that we will need on this add-on sales products. So we're going to come in here. We're going to go a new column. Again, see how I'm doing it here? I was able to click in, but I can also come up here. There's different methods, different ways. But this one is going to be hours / quantity. Here, we'll put in as a whole number. And actually, we're going to keep it as a decimal. So I don't know if they do go down to decimals. So we click here, different data types. I would say a minimum of 0. Save. This may be an adjustment that we have to make later on to a whole number. We may have to create another field. But for now, so what now, what we've built out, we have add-on sales, and we have the add-on sales products. So we have two different tables. Up next, what we're going to do is start building out and looking at doing the forms. Stay tuned.